Now begins March 18th, 2004.
Quiet and peaceable and have a few beers together and listen to the music.
Going to be quiet and peaceful, have a few beers together, and listen to some music here.
Beautiful.
And I know that a lot of you are waking up with a vicious hangover this morning. Not me. For once, it's not me.
That's nice.
This is KGB. It's Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw. Very happy to say that I am here and healthy, and I am not in the hospital having been attacked by a dog like a German man who tried to brush the teeth of his Rottweiler.
Oh, no. They don't like that.
Now, you know, you always hear stories about pit bulls and Rottweilers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And let me tell you something. In radio, in my business, if you go on the air and say, you know, pit bulls, Rottweilers, they're dangerous dogs, you don't want anything to do with them, you'll always get phone calls or emails from people who say, I have a pit bull who, you know, sleeps in my bed.
Right.
And, you know, French kisses me at night and changes my baby's diapers and, you know, the whole thing.
Yeah.
But let me tell you something. You never hear about the Labrador or the Golden Retriever that ate your children.
That's true.
You never hear about that.
Yep.
What kind of dogs were up there in San Francisco that ate that woman?
The Canary Frisia or whatever they were called.
Weren't poodles, were they?
They were not poodles.
They were the big,
sir.
Vicious, mean dog type.
Right.
They weren't Yorkshire Terriers.
No.
This guy said, he didn't understand what went wrong. Because he used a special canine toothbrush and everything. Was only able to save himself by playing dead.
Oh, my God.
Which was easy to do because he virtually bled to death.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
Have you had your morning coffee yet? Do you have to take a leak? Why don't you run right out to the Virgin Airways Clubhouse in New York's John F. Kennedy Airport? You know, Virgin Airways is not really the most conventional airline
right.
in the world. You know, I'd say they're cooler, they're hipper than anything else. I've never flown on Virgin, have you?
Have not.
No, I haven't either. I've always wanted to because it looks like fun.
Well, that's the reputation, is that we do things differently and we're the hip, cool airline.
Oh, it looks very luxurious,
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
And aren't they like... Isn't it like all first class or something like that?
Supposed to be.
Yeah.
Right.
Virgin doesn't fly through San Diego, do they?
Never see one landing at Lindbergh.
Well, at the Virgin Clubhouse at JFK, New York City, the urinals are now shaped like a woman's mouth.
Well.
All dolled up with red lipstick, wide open, ready for business. Yeah.
Whoa.
Can't wait till now hears about that. That's a little odd.
That could cause a problem. You might accidentally, involuntarily shut yourself off.
Yeah. Damn it, I wanted to, but I couldn't.
What about poor gay guys?
No kidding.
Oh, that's awful. Slam that's disgusting. Right, I can't do that.
Got little mustaches on them.
Discriminating. Do you have any John Holmes urinals in there?
Instead of ass gaskets, it'll be little mustache gaskets. So the persons can go ahead and go.
Down boy.
Final four starts today. We'll talk about that next year with Chainsaw on the KGB Good Morning.
Yeah.
Chainsaw, you ever play baseball at Yankee Stadium where they win the World Series?
No.
You ever play football down on the field at Qualcomm where they played the Super Bowl, World Championship of Football?
I have not.
Because we're taking the boys out to La Costa today for Dave's Free Thursday Golf. La Costa is, as you recall, where the Accenture World Championship of Golf was wagered.
That's the beautiful thing about golf, my friend.
Route 66, who won just weeks ago? Right here in your town, San Diego, La Costa specifically, who won the Accenture Match Play World Golf Championship?
Mark O'Meara?
No.
Wow.
At least she named a golfer.
I know. Ah.
Tiger Woods.
No.
I don't know.
Was it Tiger?
Yes, it was.
It was Tiger Woods.
He wins everything.
Tiger Woods. That's where we're going today. Thanks to Jeff Menton and thanks to the Fun Bike Center, our title sponsor. That's what we do every Thursday. We go out golfing for free. It's La Costa today.
What did you ask before if you didn't know? Wait a minute.
What'd you say?
What did you ask me a question for if you didn't know the answer?
Because I didn't know. Why else did you ask a question?
So I was automatically going to be wrong no matter what I said, huh?
I don't know. I don't know. You're the sports nut anymore.
Come on, Ruth. You're the one I go to for my trivia.
How'd you like the Lakers-Clippers game last night?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I didn't watch it.
Why didn't you watch?
No. I don't know. I couldn't find it. What channel was it on?
I don't know. It was on TV somewhere.
Cable, the Channel 5 or Channel 9.
Well, that's what you have the chainsaw for here. Okay, to bring you this sports update now on the cage. Good morning.
Well, good morning, and thank you very much, Dave Rickard, shutting down Chris Boyer, Ruth 66. Hello again, everybody, in the sports world. Speaking to Dave's point, yes, golf is just about the only sport I can think of where the general population can go on and play on the championship course, walk the same ground as a champion does. And you can't do that in baseball or basketball or a football, for that matter. You can't just go out and start play a pickup game at Qualcomm or the Super Bowl. Come on! So it's beautiful, and congratulations. Have fun today, fellas. You know, for years, I thought brackets were something to hold up bookshelves. I thought an office pool was, I didn't know what it was, billiards at the workplace, an executive swimming pool. I must tell you, in 25 years, as the revered dean of American sportscasters, only once have I filled out an NCAA bracket. And that was last year when we, here on the show, we attached annoying celebrities to each of the 64 NCAA men's college basketball tournament teams. Which crowned Sean Penn as the most annoying celebrity of 2003, his being attached to eventual champion Syracuse at the outset of last year's tournament.
I know that, dude.
And what happened to him the minute we crowned him the winner? What happened to him?
Well, he became the Oscar champion.
That's right. He went ahead and won himself his first Oscar.
Uh-huh.
You're welcome.
By the way, Sean Penn, where are you displaying your Oscar? In your home, next to the anti-war poster, or next to your gun?
Shut up.
I know that was a cheap shot and unfair. Anywho, I've managed to waste a minute of precious broadcast time avoiding any and all college basketball minutiae. Because, frankly, it kills me, too. But you can bet I'll be watching the first game at 9:20 this morning on CBS. All the way until 9 o'clock tonight. Because, apparently, I'm a degenerate gambler with no life. So, Dave, who do you like in the Valpo Gonzaga game tonight?
Gonzo.
Valpo Gonzaga will be followed by Alpo Garbanzo and then Sacco Vanzetti. That should be a good one. Sacco and Vanzetti, the two tenors, the Italian folk duo from the 60s, sang Ave Maria. I know everyone's heard of Sacco and Vanzetti, but very few people can say, you know, I think I remember that from grade school. What's Sacco and Vanzetti? Chris Boyer, Sacco and Vanzetti, please.
I don't know. Something World War One. They shot each other. I don't know.
Had it for lunch yesterday.
There was a caning in Congress.
The Philippines. I think it was Singapore. Oh, shocked, boy. Well, Ruth 66 apparently is the expert.
No,
please, we will go to Ruth.
I don't know. I'm shocked Boyer doesn't know. No.
Sacco and Vanzetti, accused of murder in the 1920s, executed in 1927. We learned about them in civics class. They were Italian alien anarchists who legal experts believe were convicted and executed more for their anti-government philosophies than the evidence in the murder trial. Supposed to teach us to judge by the facts, not by a predisposition of disdain or annoyance.
Isn't that interesting?
No.
Yeah.
Very educational, Chainsaw. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. Meanwhile, in the National
Grew up in South Philadelphia. That's where I'm from originally, Philadelphia. Hey, how you doing? Tough Italian neighborhood. Went back a couple years ago. I met this guy in a bar. Hardly knew him. He got shot in his leg 6 inches from his crotch. Decides to tell me about it. Runs up to me. Doesn't even say hello. Goes, Stevie, I can't believe you get shot in the leg 6 inches from my Babylones. He's doing this for a half hour. I don't know what this is. This is the dance of the Babylones, I guess. 6 inches from his Babylones. Kind of gives you an insight into some men's mentality. It's obvious the way some of us think because, let's face it, he could have got shot directly through the head. And it would have been, Steve, you can't believe it. Get shot in the head 3 feet from my Babylones. I'm telling you, man, a neighbor of mine got shot 2 blocks away from my Babylones. You know that stuff in the Middle East? What is that? 9,000 miles from my Babylones, man.
Skipball Association. Ruthie, your Lakers beat the Clippers 106-103.
Wow.
Seven other games, none with such a fascinating result. In Padre action yesterday, Padre pitcher Jake Peavy's first pitch to Barry Bonds yesterday ended up 410 feet behind him. Yeah, it kept Barry Bonds really laced one. It kept from being a home run because it hit 20 feet up on that wall in straightaway center field, the batter's eye. The wall built exceptionally high to give hitters a solid visual background, the so-called batter's eye. 410 feet, 20 feet up on the wall. You know, steroids, growth hormones, whatever. The guy can see it and hit it. Giants beat the Padres 7-4. Padres now 6-9 the spring. In other sports, David.
You know, in the spirit of competition, I was going to go ahead and check and see how the bidding is going on the Hamwell Open with our foursomes.
Yes.
But maybe I shouldn't because it might be hurtful to Emily and Chucko.
Huh. Oh.
That's too bad. I'll just assume.
This one. 6:33 and 9 seconds.
Oh, my.
This is your 101.5 KJB Sports Network.
Oh, boy, man. Who's singing, Ruth?
The three tenors. Andy Williams.
Can you name the three tenors?
Kind of sounds like
Pavarotti.
Andy.
What is it?
Pavarotti.
Yeah. And the other two.
Yeah, the other two guys. Yeah. The dark Domingo? Hair and the gray hair guy.
What?
Is one of them Placido Domingo?
I don't know.
Yes.
Yes.
That's why I ask.
And then that other guy.
Yeah. Is one guy the blind guy?
No.
No.
That's Bocelli.
Who?
Andrea Bocelli.
Yeah.
Oh. Luca de Beppo.
Oh, God, I love Luca de Beppo.
I know.
Anyone got the identity of this singer?
What's
Perry Como. It is
Perry Como. Oh.
I see your shell.
Wow.
And Buca di Beppo is a really cool Italian restaurant.
Oh.
All over now.
They make good pizza. Chainsaw brought to you by the La Costa Resort and Spa. That's where we're golfing today for Dave's Free Thursday Golf. You can, too. For the first time ever, play the tournament course at La Costa. Call 760-385-GOLF. It's 760-385-GOLF or go to lacosta.com. And here's Route 66.
Thank you so much. Bumper to bumper out of South Bay, North 805 from Plaza up through North Park. South 5 heavy on the coast from Palomar Airport Road off and on to Encinitas and then down to Manchester as well. South 15 slows El Norte Parkway to West Bernardo. Then more brake lights from Carmel Mountain to Mercy. Spring is here, and it's the perfect time to feed your garden with Miracle-Gro Shake and Feed slow-release plant food. A few minutes of shake time, 3 months of showtime. I'm Ruth 66 with ESC 101.5 KGB.
This is KGB. It's Dave Shelley and Chainsaw. What occupation in America turns out the funniest people?
Comedian?
Sure. But people who aren't a comedian for a profession, what would you say?
Well, I always thought the bartenders and waitresses had to think on the fly. And,
yeah, some of them are pretty clever.
People. Yep. Yeah.
Yep.
How about, like, ER surgeons? Guys joking about, hey, guess what we found up there?
Boy, I don't know. ER surgeons I've run into.
Really?
Not that funny.
Salespeople.
Yeah, you think?
Patter.
How about United States senators?
No.
Funniest people?
No.
Well, I'll tell you what. There's a thing I found online, thanks to a listener who emailed this to me. This guy pretended to be a 10-year-old boy, and he wrote a letter to all senators in America. Ruth 66, how many senators are there in America?
50.
No.
How many?
100.
Oh, yeah. Two for each state. I knew that.
That's why I said 50.
I'm busting your balls. And he wrote this letter. Let me see if I can find it. I'll read you the letter. It's pretty clever. He wrote it. You know, it looks like a 10-year-old boy wrote it. Yeah. It says, "Dear Senator, my name is John Hargrave, and I am in the fifth grade at Fisher Elementary School in Wesley, Massachusetts. For my school's social studies class, Mrs. Rawson assigned us a government project. I want to be a comedian when I grow up, so I am writing every U.S. senator and asking what their favorite joke is. Please send your joke on the included form. Sincerely, Josh Hargrove, age 10.
What an enterprising young man.
No, it's not a 10-year-old. It's a guy.
It's a guy.
Pretending to be a 10-year-old.
So what did he get?
It's a scam, Jane. Total scam. Says, right off the bat, I discovered that getting a response from a top elected official is not an easy task, even for a 10-year-old boy. Weeks passed with no response. The reason for the delay, I later discovered, was that all 100 joke letters were screened for traces of chemical residue in accordance with the new Homeland Security regulations. Uh-huh. Federal marshals wearing protective suits held the prank messages up to ultraviolet lights with long tweezers. Trained dogs sniffed hungrily over the letters, their keen noses able to detect anything except the scent of a practical joke. Finally, the letters went through, and I pestered our nation's senators by email until finally the responses started coming in. Senators actually took the time from their busy schedules to write a joke and send it to me. Well, not to me, but to a lying 10-year-old kid. But the results, I can guarantee, will both amuse and amaze you as you discover which of our senators are funny and which are not. You'll be moved to such a degree that you might even be tempted to vote. Are you ready to hear some of them?
Yes.
Anybody in particular you want to hear from?
Let's hear from R2.
They did not respond.
How about Ted Kennedy?
Ted Kennedy.
He's got to know some jokes.
Yeah.
Ted Kennedy did not respond. Well, no, wait. He didn't respond to the original letter, and so the guy doing the scam did the whole email pester thing.
Right.
And this is what he received. This is an automatically generated delivery status notification. Delivery to the following recipients failed. Senator Kennedy.
That's funny.
That's funny.
Let me
give you some of the jokes that came back from the senators, okay? The guys who did respond.
Okay.
Democrat Kent Conrad. Ruth 66, what state does Kent Conrad serve?
How about Kansas?
No.
In the Midwest someplace?
No. Maybe. I don't know. I can't tell.
Do we need a map?
It's South Dakota, Dave.
It's North Dakota, Jane.
Oh. Told you. God, I was close.
Yes.
A wild guess.
Senator Conrad, the only guy who actually hand wrote the joke out on the form that the kids sent in.
Wow.
Wrote this one. Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson
are strolling through a park and see three ladies on a bench.
No, no.
Damn, that's one of my favorites.
Shoot, I lost it. Hang on a second here. Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson go on a camping trip. Oh, they always do. No Vaseline and leaves.
Okay. Zip two sleeping bags together to make it one.
After a good dinner, they retired for the night and went to sleep. Some hours later, Holmes awakes and nudges his faithful friend. Watson, look up at the sky and tell me what you see. I see millions and millions of stars, he replies. And what do you deduce from that? Watson ponders for a minute. Well, astronomically, it tells me that there are millions of galaxies, potentially billions of planets. Astrologically, I assume Saturn is in Leo. He goes on and on. I deduce there is probably it may be a quarter past three. Meteorologically, I've never been able to say that word.
Meteorological.
It's meteorologically. God, I have difficulty.
That's how you said it.
I suspect that we will have a beautiful day tomorrow. What does it tell you, Holmes? Holmes, silent for a moment, says, Watson, you idiot, it tells me that someone stole our tent.
That's pretty funny.
That's not bad. Ben Campbell. Who does he serve, Ruth 66?
Missouri.
No.
He was the guitar player, wasn't he?
The other Dakota. I don't know.
Colorado.
Okay. Ask Abramowitz. Spain. Crud.
Thank you for writing and ask me about my favorite joke. I represent the great state of Colorado. And my favorite joke is, why did the pig have ink all over his face?
Because he was a pig pen.
Because it came out of the pen.
Whatever.
Close enough.
Shut up. At least it didn't start with, so Kobe walks into a spa.
What's the matter? What's the matter?
It's just, wasn't his best work, maybe.
You think?
Well.
John Corzine. Who does he represent?
Illinois. Dave Corzine, the former Bulls center.
Very close, Chainsaw. Massachusetts. What but I love the confidence. I love the confidence that you give.
You bet.
I wouldn't have questioned it.
What did the number 0 say to the number 8?
Nice waistline.
Very close. Nice belt.
Okay.
Very close. Okay, Larry Craig representing
Florida.
Idaho.
Massachusetts.
Oh. Okay.
These are the great jokes you're getting.
We've already been through both of them.
Why did the farmer plow his field with a steamroller?
Because
this is easy. Come on.
Like pizza. He was like
mashed potatoes.
Mashed potatoes.
Mashed potatoes. Yeah. Okay. Tom Daschle representing
Minnesota.
Missouri.
South Idaho.
Dakota.
Come on, idiot. God.
Daschle. You just want to hit him.
Yeah.
I always try to include some humor in my speeches. This is actually kind of a funny story. No, it really is. This is kind of a funny story.
Just want to hit him.
I always try to include some humor in my speeches. I think the best kind of humor is a good-natured, in fact, if I poke fun at anyone, it's at myself. Oh, that's typical of politicians. Mm-hmm. They're always turning it towards themselves.
Very self-deprecating, Tom Daschle.
Yeah, they never accuse their competitors of anything. One of the stories I use that always gets a laugh isn't really a joke. It's a true story. One evening shortly after the anthrax letter was opened in my office, I came home from work and a member of my security team told me, sort of sheepishly, that he'd made a big mistake. A package had been mailed to my house that day. Printed on the box, the officer saw the words, Jerk of the Month. He figured he had an emergency and he called the bomb squad. Turns out it was my monthly shipment of beef jerky from a company in South Dakota. Chuck Hagel, representing?
Mississippi, David.
You haven't got any right yet.
Yeah, I have.
Come on. Which one?
The ones you changed, once you heard the right
answer. Yes, anybody.
Louisiana.
I got $5 that no one's going to get it. What's his Boyer?
What's Hagel's from Missouri.
No.
Ruth? Georgia.
You already took your guess there, Mouthy. Ruth?
Hawaii.
How about I look it up and tell you?
Can't find it on the list.
Nebraska, you kook.
Oh, yeah, right. That's right. Is that even a state?
My favorite joke was sent to me by a high school Latin club in Florida.
Oh, yay. Illegitimi non carborundum.
What did you just do?
That's the punchline.
Is that Latin?
I think it means don't let the bastards grind you down. Something like that.
Latin isn't dead. It's just roaming around.
Ah,
jeez.
That's his favorite. You know, these guys are so. Because, you know, when these guys get together.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
In their wood-lined little smoking halls. So there's Pollock.
Nah.
Goes up to the hooker. All right, now this one I think you can get. Orrin Hatch. Chainsaw.
Utah.
You got it, buddy. Good job. You want Orrin Hatch, you know.
He's funny.
Laugh,
sexy,
riot.
Old.
I was delighted to read your letter asking me for my favorite joke. I believe a sense of humor will serve you well in any career field you enter. I often use comedy in my work. One joke that I truly enjoy is, Learn from the mistakes of others. You can never live long enough to make them all yourself.
Was there supposed to be something funny in there?
Apparently, that's his favorite joke. Orrin Hatch, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. Ronnie, what do you think about that?
Forgive me, but that's hogwash.
Ron. All right, I got $5 that says you can't do this. Without cheating, please.
Yeah.
Ernest Hollings.
Boyer.
West Virginia.
Maryland.
No. Ruth.
Never heard of him.
Shell.
Arkansas.
No.
It's regular Virginia.
Regulars. South Carolina. Ernest Hollings. Have you heard one that you thought was funny yet?
Well, I chuckled at one. I can't remember what.
I thought
the Sherlock Holmes joke.
The Sherlock Holmes joke was pretty good. But the rest of them have been lame, haven't they?
Yeah.
This guy, Ernest Hollings, this is what he writes. Many thanks for your letter informing me of your government project. I regret that I do not have one favorite joke to send you, because I believe maintaining a good sense of humor is essential to a healthy, happy, and successful life. Therefore, equally appreciate all jokes I've ever heard or told.
Oh, what a piece of crap.
What a senator.
Incredibly racist one.
What a total senator.
During the Tom Crow years.
What a total senator. I like every joke I've ever told or heard. All right.
Jim Crow.
Let's see what Barbara Mikulski. Anyone?
Marilyn.
Yes. How'd you know that?
Because I've heard of her.
Because I cheated.
I have a list. No. Booked her on a talk show once.
Why didn't the skeleton cross the road?
He didn't have the guts.
It's a burn joke. For 10 years old, that could be funny.
And then Barbara wrote an alternate punchline, which is very political.
Mm-hmm.
P.S. Or you could say, because he didn't have the guts to stand up for what he believed in.
Oh, jeez.
Come on, where's the one?
Funny.
What?
Where's the one with the boy? What do you name your dog, buddy? We call him Porky. I mean,
you call him Porky because he...
Why do you call him Porky? Because he likes to eat a lot?
No, because he likes to screw pigs.
John Kyle. Anybody.
Is that Oklahoma?
No.
Arizona.
It is Arizona.
I knew it was someplace I'd lived.
One too many guesses. I was working in my garden one weekend and realized I needed some extra plants. So I dressed in my grubbies and baseball cap. I went to the nursery to find some plants. When I paid for the stuff, the clerk looked at me quizzically and said, "Did anyone ever tell you that you look like John Kyle?" I said, "Yes." He said, "I'll bet it makes you real mad, doesn't it?"
That's funny. That one.
Not bad. John McCain.
Arizona. Isn't he?
No, Ruth. He's California. On, Ruth. Come on. How do you not know that one?
Do you read a newspaper ever?
He's your own senator, you goon.
Yeah.
Yes, he is.
Haven't you been to me, McCain Barbara, Valley?
We got broads running the show here.
No, we don't. No. It's John McCain. It's John McCain and Hillary Clinton.
New York.
Here's my favorite joke. I feel terrible for all the mothers in the state of Arizona because, as you know, Barry Goldwater from Arizona ran for president of the United States. Morris Udall from Arizona ran for president. Bruce Babbitt from Arizona ran for president. And I, John McCain from Arizona, ran for president of the United States. Arizona may be the only state in the nation where mothers no longer tell their children someday they can grow up and be president of the United States.
You're back. I missed you and your laugh. Oh, I think it's funny, too.
And for those of you who haven't been with us long enough, this is actually Senator John McCain laughing at his own joke.
Yeah. When he made the run for the White House.
That's really unfortunate.
And we knew that he would never make it.
Finally, ladies and gentlemen, the great senator from Massachusetts who wants to be your president of the United States.
And his name is Kerry.
He says, "We have a new chaplain in the Senate, and a tour came through the other day. They asked him a lot of questions about being a chaplain, and one person turned to him and said, 'When you open the Senate with prayer each morning, do you look out at the senators? Do you pray for them?' The chaplain didn't lose a beat. He said, no, actually, I look at all those senators, and I pray for our country. Oh. Deep.
But he said it a lot slower than that.
Oh, you know, if I read it like him, we'd be here till noon. So there's your funny, funny senators.
Wow.
And no, I know you're wondering, what was Hillary's favorite joke?
So you happen to have an eraser.
Bill, I want you to go to the theater, Bill. Let me just tell you, if you get those two punchlines without the setup, I'm very, very, very proud of you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Inspired, a round of Stump the Joke Czar. Let's do it now. 888-570-1015. It's a direct connect here at the KGB. Don't I have golf at La Costa? I know I do.
Yes.
I have golf at La Costa. If you can stump the joke czar, you know the rules of me. What?
You won't do it.
Of course you won't. No, you won't do it. You know why you won't do it?
Why?
Because not only do you have the joke czar on the wall, where you want me on that wall, you need me on that wall.
Wish you were there now.
You, thank you. You have the count of the court of kooks. And the newly appointed, what would you like to be? Sergeant of the joke troops, Ruth 66.
Yeah!
No, I want to be the czarina.
No.
Be the gunny.
You have miles to go before you're going to sit next to me. The czarina.
Come on, it took me 4 years before Dave would ever allow me to sit on his right hand.
You don't sit on my right hand, you sit at my feet.
At his right hand, I'm sorry.
Jeez, I sit alone at the top of the hill, make no mistakes.
A little throat after all.
Chainsaw is, of course, the corporal of the Court of Kooks.
Yeah, but I've been... had my stripes ripped off.
Oh,
many
man.
Times.
He's ceremoniously just dressed down.
Yeah.
But Ruth is the sergeant because of her uncanny ability to crack such punchlines as, why do women wear makeup and perfume?
Because they're ugly and they stink. Terrible joke.
Why do you tell it all the time?
Ah. You make me. You make me.
Make me.
Make me. Make me do it.
You know, that should be used more often and practical, you know.
Make me. Make me.
Kobe and Robert Blake ought to be able to use that, you know, sitting there on the stand. Aren't you guilty? Tell me. Tell me if you're guilty.
Make me.
Make me. All right, Stump the Joke Czar for your passes to golf at La Casa, 888-570-1015. Direct connect here with KGB. Remember, it's got to be funny. It's that tricky part about telling a joke. It's got to be funny. Here is the hilarious Ruth 66.
Thanks so much. Slow traffic out of Alcohol and westbound 8, Las Cruces to Greenfield, then heavy around Spring Street through La Mesa. Westbound 94, heavy from Federal off and on into downtown. North 805 slows in the South Bay from Plaza up to the 94, then again Claremont Mesa to the 52, then again La Jolla Village. Southbound 5 slows Las Flores to Palomar Airport Road, then La Costa is solid to Manchester. South 15 slows El Norte Parkway to Via Rancho, then Bernardo Center to Mercy. And northbound 15 slows from Fairmont to 8. Finding your dream home is easy with KB Home's many communities throughout San Diego and South Riverside counties. Visit kbhome.com and find your home today. I'm Ruth 66 with ESC 101.5 KGB.
This is KGB. It's Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw trying to send you golfing to La Costa. Would you like to go to La Costa? Who wouldn't?
Yeah.
Go golfing out there where the world championship is played? Who wouldn't want to go? You want to go, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, call me and you'll be denied. It's not going to happen. You think you're getting one past us? I don't think so. Bring me your best gas. No, we're not going to hit it out of the park. We're going to hit it right back at your head. Jeez, what the hell's wrong with
him? I don't know. You got a little too much sleep last night, baby.
I did. I swear. God, I am so charged.
Good, isn't it?
God, I was...
Did you go to bed at 6 o'clock?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. No, it wasn't that early. I think I got like a grand total, like 6 hours sleep, but...
Yeah. It's it was so just refreshing. So good.
Yeah.
Right.
Eight 570 1015 Direct Connect. Gonna try and get one past us. Here we go, Mike. You're first up here on the KHB. What's going on, Mike? Did it pick up? Didn't pick up. There it is. Hey, Mike.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Good. You're the first person to compete this morning on Stump the Joke Czar.
Uh oh. Well, you ready?
Yeah.
All right. What type of bees give milk?
Hey, Mike.
Yes.
I'm gonna make a rash assessment here. I've been doing this job for a long time. Talked to a lot of people. I don't know how many tens of thousands of listeners I've talked to in my career. But I'm gonna make an assessment based on my experience that you are not a 12-year-old little girl. Are you a 12-year-old little girl?
No, I'm a 14-year-old girl.
Well, then it makes sense that you're telling me this joke. Mike, how old are you?
I'm sorry?
How old are you?
27.
27?
Yes.
And you're telling me this joke?
That's the best joke I can come up with.
Wow.
You could be a senator of the United States of America. Seriously, I don't know what you're doing these days, but the minute you get to the minimum age, I would run for senator. What kind of bees give milk? Mike, do you use this to impress the chicks?
Does it work?
Right.
Do you use this joke to impress the chicks?
No, I don't.
Good. Boobies, Mike.
Get it? Boobies.
That's funny.
And Mike, please tell me, Mike, please tell me that other than your unfortunate, your very unfortunate joke, please tell... Yes, Fern?
No, I think it's funny. Go ahead, what are you saying?
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Mike, please tell me that other than your unfortunate joke, that you'll never, ever use the word booby.
That's why I thought it was so funny.
Just
boobies. Vern! Darn.
Good night. You like Vern, don't you, Ruth?
I love Vern. He makes everything funny.
Did you hear, I think I can tell this. One of the women here in the office yesterday was walking through the halls, and she said, she mentioned to us casually what her date did on a first date.
Oh, I didn't hear this.
You know, there's some things that you feel like you can get away with, and some things that you can't get away with.
Right.
And this woman, by the way, who was like, kind of like, I don't know, you know, if you had to describe her... You know, like as someone famous that you would know, you know, like Nicole Kidman or something like that. I'd maybe go like Darth Vader. I don't know. She frightens me.
Uh-huh.
This guy snapped her bra.
Oh my God.
On a first date.
Wow. Oh my God.
On a first date.
Was gonna work?
Oh my God.
Snapped her bra. And I said, well, what'd you do? And she held up her finger.
Uh-huh.
She held up her forefinger, like the number one. She goes, you do that to me to one time. You do that to me one time. Like Joe Piscopo and Johnny Dangerously. My mother did that to me once.
My mother. What about my mother?
My mama.
I'm trying to figure out. Sometimes, you know, these women say there's no good guys out there. I'm like, yes, there are. There's plenty of good guys out there. Maybe there are.
Maybe not. Possibly not.
Guy who snaps a bra on a first date?
Well, at least he didn't bring her a butt plug to wear to a wedding. You know? We've heard about that.
It can always be worse, right?
Emily, write this down. I want to do this bit. First date disaster. Oh, write that down. Okay. I mean, and maybe I want to do this later on this morning. First date disaster. We would put, I think... Having your bra snapped and being the recipient of a big black butt plug that he wanted you to wear.
Request.
For the date.
Yes, exactly. I was hoping you'd wear that tonight. You don't mind.
I don't know.
That's going to be the king of all time.
Oh, I'm sure it won't be.
How can you beat that?
I'm trying to figure that out. You know, if a date says to you, you know, I'm wearing Victoria's Secret under here, maybe it'd be all, you know, hey,
sure,
all right.
Yeah.
But if your date says, you know, I'm wearing a great big... I'd be like, oh, no.
What?
What's wrong?
Why? Oh.
Maybe there are no good guys out there. I don't know. All right, Justin, you're next here on Stump the Jokes Are. You will fail. Go ahead.
Hey, what's up, Dave?
Just waiting to crush your spirit.
All right. What does the Starship Enterprise and toilet paper have in common?
They both circle Uranus in search of Klingons.
Oh!
Good night now!
No!
Joe, you're on KGB.
Dave, you slutty little douche.
I'm ready.
You're ready.
I'm not going to engage you in mindless chit-chat. We're just going to efficiently crush your hopes and desires.
Okie dokie. Why couldn't Helen Keller drive?
Because she's dead.
No.
Because she's a woman.
Don't tell me that's the punchline.
It's not. Would you like it?
No, hang on. We're still considering. Why couldn't Helen Keller drive? No. You know what? I didn't mention this. But it is funny, isn't it, Joe?
Absolutely.
Why, Joe? Why couldn't Helen Keller drive?
She was a woman.
We said that.
I said.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you... I got it.
Hang up and shake.
Hi, Colleen.
Hi.
Happy St. Patrick's Day. One day late to you. I know you're Irish.
Yeah, I am. Yeah, my dad's Irish, but my mom's brown, so, you know.
Damn it. Damn it. Brown and green, mix them together. You know what you get.
Exactly. I'm a high-headed alcoholic.
Do you have a vicious hangover today?
No, I was lame. I didn't even do anything.
Oh, Colleen. Oh. What's your deal?
I don't know.
You saving up for Cinco de Mayo or something?
Well, we're going on vacation next week, so I guess I'll save it up for that.
Right.
That's really not good enough either, but I'll just, whatever. My joke is, what did the potato chip say to the battery?
So you should have gone out last night. You'd have gotten a better joke than that one. If you're free to... Wait a minute. If you're ever ready, I'm free to lay. Oh, yeah, Colleen. How'd I get that one? You look them up. You got a book. You're on the internet. You're cheating, man.
So that was the original joke from which came the funny, funny... Frito-Lay, Kenneth Lay's wife. Her name is Frito-Lay. She's Frito-Lay. Is that where that came from?
I don't think that was the derivation, but there.
It's another
like
ugly
that,
Dave Shelley and Chainsaw moment that I have successfully blocked. So I don't know. I don't even remember
it.
Yeah. All right, maybe Spencer, you're next here on Stump the Jokes Are. Hi, Spencer.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, man.
All right. Why do blondes wear hoop earrings on dates?
Place for them to rest their ankles. You're way too young to be telling that joke, dude. See ya. Emily, am I clear through 6 o'clock?
Yep.
Really?
Wow.
This is first of 7.
How'd that happen?
You're just that good.
What'd I do? What's that all about? Adam, you're next here on Stump the Jokes Are. Let's hear it.
What'd the bartender say to the horse?
Why the long face? Victoria is next here on KGB.
Okay, a lady walks into a Mercedes dealership and she reaches over to touch the leather in the seat. And when she leans over, she farts. She's really, really embarrassed. And so she looks around to see if anybody noticed. Excuse me. And she looks behind her and the salesman's right behind her and she tries to cover up her faux pas. And she says, yes, can you please tell me how much this fine automobile is? And the salesman says,
you know, a lady named Victoria should never say the word fart.
Passes gas.
You should say toot or something like that. Far too classy. I mean, you are posh spice, after all.
Oh, you recognize my voice.
Yeah. How much is for this fine vehicle? And the salesman says, I give up.
Really? Everybody give up?
Yeah, you're up. What does he say?
Okay. He says, if you farted when you touched it, you're going to crap when you hear the price.
Okay, all right, that's good. That's pretty good. All right, we have a winner. Do you golf, Victoria?
I'm sorry?
Do you golf?
No.
Do you know someone who would like to go golfing?
You.
I win!
Wow!
Well, hold on. We do have your prize for you here. That's our first winner today here. Impressive, wow. Victoria.
Thank you very much.
Nicely done, girl. Hold on. We will continue. Stump the Joke Czar will bookend Chainsaw Sports, which is next here on the KGB. First, here's Ruth.
Slow traffic continues for North County drivers southbound on 5 from
Hello? What? Something shiny went by.
All the way down to Manchester. Yeah. Slow traffic south 15. Packed solid now from El Norte Parkway all the way to Mercy. Very foggy there. Slow traffic in the South Bay north on 805 from Plaza to the 94, then Claremont Mesa to the 52. Northbound 5 heavy through National City in the South Bay. Westbound 94 heavy from Federal into downtown. Westbound 8 from Spring to Fletcher. This Friday through Sunday, get to Qualcomm Stadium for the giant used car tent sale. Over 2,000 cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs from San Diego's best dealers must be sold. Trade-ins are welcome. Financing available. The giant used car tent sale, Qualcomm, from Friday at 12 p.m. through Sunday at 9 p.m. I'm Ruth 66 with DSC.
We are going to continue with Stump the Joke Czar, but first, let's go ahead and crush Bill's spirits. Bill?
Morning, Dave.
Bring it.
Got one for Lucy here.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Why do women rub their eyes when they get up in the morning?
Come on!
Easy count.
Something about tea bag?
No. Because they can't scratch their Babylons. Why don't you just hang up the phone? Thank you. More of that domination coming on the other side of the sports with Chainsaw here on KGB.
Hello again, everybody. In the sports world, we are 2 hours away, just 2 hours away from round one of the NCAA Men's College Basketball Tournament. 9:40 to be precise in terms of television, although there's another game a little earlier. Maryland versus UTEP. UTEP went 24-7 this regular season, an unbelievable turnaround from last year when they won only 6 games the entire season. While 19-11, Maryland went from a bubble team to a number 4 seed thanks to their sensational run that culminated with an Atlantic Coast Conference tournament title. You know, last year, to make it interesting here on the show, we coincided the NCAA's with the 64 most annoying celebrities in the world, and Sean Penn attached to eventual champion Syracuse at the outset. He was crowned champion, which served, of course, as a springboard to his first Oscar victory.
Mm-hmm.
Something for which we take credit. This year we were considering attaching our favorite movies to the 64 teams. Could you imagine The Godfather being a number 1 seed against 16 seed Police Academy 5? You know, one of those early round blowouts.
Mm. Well, who's putting Police Academy on their top 16?
That would be controversial that they even made the NCAAs.
Yeah.
Or 2 seed Shawshank Redemption versus number 15 seed Over the Top, the great Sylvester Stallone arm wrestling movie. And like Police Academy 5, I'd be surprised if Over the Top even made the NCAAs. They're not even an NIT team at best. I mean, come on! But we nixed the overall idea when we found out that Scarface and Reefer Madness tested positive for substance abuse. Although the Beaches Steel Magnolia showdown was much anticipated by the ladies in the room. Did you know?
Kind of like that idea.
Do you like the idea?
I
we
like
have
the idea.
2 hours left.
You want to do it? Because
sure.
What it does is it determines, just like last year,
mm-hmm.
when we determine who is the most annoying celebrity of all time, it will determine what is the greatest movie of all time, whether we agree or not, because
that's right.
We let the basketball teams determine it.
We'll have to throw out, I mean, is Citizen Kane going to get a number 1 seed in one of the brackets?
No.
Well, why not?
I mean, it's been ballyhooed as the greatest film of all time, I would imagine, by our own determination, that The Godfather would be a number 1 seed somewhere.
One of us is going
to
put it in there.
Right.
There's 4 brackets, right?
4 brackets,
four
1
brackets.
Through 16.
Yeah, and the 4 of us choose 16 of our favorite movies.
Right.
We can do it if you want.
Let's do it.
All right.
We'll do it after the culmination of the Stump the Joke Czar.
All right.
Because we have until 9:25, David, because once that game tips off, we cannot bastardize or pollute or, you know.
Justice wouldn't stand
right.
for it.
It'd be illegal in a gambling context. All right. Did you know that the 2004 Summer Olympics are fast approaching?
And with 5 months to go, it appears that construction of many of the venues will not be completed in time. How bad is it? Athens hasn't even inflated the pool yet. Runners might want to roll up and pack their own lane of track. This could be the first Olympics that features hammering during the hammer throw. For the first time in Olympic history, swimmers will suffer road rash. Gymnastics will be just called nastics because there's no gym. So there you have it. Venues for the Athens Games may not be completed in time for this summer's event. Meanwhile, in the national event,
you got to go to college. You got to get a good job, right? Women want guys with money, right? I actually like my bank teller, but I'm afraid to ask her out because I think she'll just punch up my account and go, I don't think so. I don't know. I don't date. You know why I don't date? I'm single now. I like it because I can't fight, you know? And I'm so afraid of getting beat up in front of a woman. That freaks me out, you know? I mean, I don't mind getting beat up in front of a guy, but when there's a woman around, I get so nervous. And the last woman I dated, she's like, would you fight for me? I was like, I don't even fight for myself, Steve. You can run with me, because that's what I do. We can hold hands while we run, keep it romantic. But you got to keep up, because I book. I'm going to get my ass kicked, because you broke a heel.
Skatball Association. There were 8 games last night, but the most important one for Ruth 66 was the Lakers beat the Clippers 106-103. The question is, how does the Fab Four beat the lowly Clippers only by 3, Ruth 66?
That's pretty scary, huh?
Yes, it is. Thank you for that report. In other sports, David?
We're never happy with the Lakers, are we? It, you know, a win is a win, but it wasn't a good enough win. It's an all-star team, man. They got to beat the Clippers by more than 3.
Yep.
And so, you know what? I bet it's tough to beat them.
Especially during the dregs of the season where everyone's saying, oh, can we just get to the playoffs already?
You know, it must be. I'll bet it is tough to be the Lakers, seriously, because everyone who comes to Staples is up for that game.
Yep.
They are getting up for that all-star team, you know?
Malone, 17, O'Neal, 21, Kobe Bryant, 27, and Gary Payton, 10.
I like statistics.
It is 7:33 at 35 seconds. And this is your 101.5 KGB Sports Network.
All right, this traffic update, and then we are right back in your grill with Stump the Joke Star. Here's Ruth.
Slow traffic westbound 8, now Jackson Drive all the way down to Waring Road, then again at Texas and some more in Hotel Circle. Westbound 94, heavy College Grove way off and on into downtown. North 805 slows from Plaza to the 94, then Claremont Mesa to the 52. North 5 slows through National City. South 5 heavy Poinsettia solid all the way to Manchester. South 15 packed from El Norte Parkway all the way down to Mercy. Brought to you by Kohl's Department Store. 5 new San Diego area Kohl's Department Stores open Friday, April 16th. Urban Pipeline, U.S. Polo, Ocean, Pacific, and many more. Kohl's has all the hot brands for young men and boys at cool prices. I'm Ruth 66 with DSC 101.5 KGB.
From San Diego, it's KGB and KGBB. For our buddies in the Inland Empire, how perfect was yesterday?
Oh, beautiful.
I mean, if you weren't at the beach.
Yeah.
The beach blew.
Kind of foggy.
Sante killed yesterday.
Yes.
It's a great day to not be a La Jolla rich bastard and be living in Sante.
It was kind of nice in La Jolla, too. Just depends on where you go.
It's pretty murky.
I don't know. People were bringing me food and drink, and it was just fine.
I was talking about the weather.
Oh, yeah. The weather sucked.
Not your rich bastard life.
That part was good.
Hey, Lise.
Hey.
What's up, girl?
How are you doing?
Better now that you're on the show.
Love your show.
How are you doing?
I'm fine. Listen, I'm in a pissy-ass mood this morning because during the commercial break, I listened to Mason, and there's just something about that guy that just pisses me off. And
Now you know what it's like to work here. We hate him.
And my shrink
has denied me my Zoloft prescription.
Uh-oh.
I don't have my happy pills.
Homicide.
Well, Mason called your shrink and told him to deny it.
Why won't he give you Zoloft?
Because his secretary answered the phone.
So what? Well, they think it'd take too much or something, or what?
No, they don't. They want me to come in and see him.
Oh, that. Yeah, got to have the doctor's office visit charge first.
Yeah, doctor's office visit, $65, which I don't have.
For the 10 minutes for him to write out on a piece of paper.
That's right.
Yeah, I know.
Exactly. Yeah. So anyway, could you please torment Mason this morning?
You know, if he goes out for a smoke and he's got his little transistor radio, I'll run in and take over his radio station for him again.
It would make my day.
All right. Thanks, Lise.
Bye.
See you. There goes pissy ass Lisa.
Wow. No Zoloft.
Yikes.
Terrible.
That's a direct connect to losing, because you're not going to smack us on Stump the Jokes Are. No. You ready, Count?
Come on, bring it on.
I took the first round solo. Here we go. Brent, you're on Stump the Jokes Are. If you beat us, you're going golfing at La Costa. Prepare to fail. Go.
Why was Raggedy Ann thrown out of the toy box?
Why was Raggedy Ann thrown out of the toy box?
Oh,
I know this one. I swear I know this one. Why are we doing this?
I don't know.
Oh, no. Come on. I know this one. Give me a hint, Brent. I'll get it. I promise. Brent?
Yeah.
Brent, are you suffering from a stroke this morning or something?
Need your Zoloft or what?
Yeah. Give me a hint, Brent.
No hints. I want those tickets.
No hints.
Something about Raggedy Andy? Is it something...
I know this one, and it's going to... And it's a good joke, too. It's a winner.
Because her mouth is so shut?
No. Okay, Brent, why was Raggedy Ann thrown out of the toy box?
Because she kept sitting on Pinocchio's face.
No. You can't... Come on, that makes Michael Powell cry. Don't talk about that kind of stuff.
Was that the answer or no?
Yeah, but if I'd known that's what it was, can't do that. It's a new world that we live in.
Shall I make a note of that, jokes are? Okay, you got it?
I think I protected us enough from that one. And there is a better Raggedy Ann joke out there. That's not the one that I was thinking of.
I can't remember.
Matt, you're next here on Stump the Jokes Are. Let's hear it.
Dave.
You're stupid and gay.
That's
the way I like it.
Guy's been drinking all day. Walks out of the bar completely faced. Other side of the street walks a nun. He walks across the street, just walks up, pops her in the face.
Oh.
Hits her as hard as he can. And she falls down and he starts beating her and then grabs her by the robes, picks her up, looks her eye to eye and says...
What? What's he say?
You ain't so effing tough tonight, are you, Batman?
You know, there's that critical, it's got to be funny part.
Yeah.
See, we want to laugh. We desperately want to laugh. Let's try another nun joke here with Miles. What's going on?
Hey, guys, how you doing this morning?
Tip top. You ever run into another Miles?
Actually, I have. My dad's named the same thing.
other than the guy you're named after, have you ever run into another Miles?
Actually, yeah, I have a couple.
Okay, great. Let's hear.
Anyway, all right. What was inscribed on the nun's tombstone?
I got $5 that said this won't be funny.
It won't. Yeah. Never had it, never will. I don't know.
All right, what?
Returned unopened. Come on, guys.
You know, a lady can change her mind after she's been opened and become a nun.
That's not even true.
Why'd I have to put the person voice on
I
that
don't
one?
Know.
I don't know. Is it Lewis or Luis?
Lewis.
Lewis, what's going on?
I want this one for Ruth.
Okay.
Ruth.
Yeah.
What's green and smells like pork?
Do we know this one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
Everybody don't know knows it. This one.
Everyone
I
knows
I don't
it.
Remember.
Children know this.
Then take a boy.
Unborn children know this one. What's green and smells like pork, Ruth?
I have to pass.
Huh?
I have to pass.
No, you don't pass.
Come
we
on.
Don't. We don't pass.
Yes. Come on.
We don't.
Know.
We're ball
Think
hogs. We don't pass.
I don't know.
Think pork.
No idea.
Who's famous pork? A famous pork.
The pig.
What pig?
The porky pig.
Try a lady pig, a famous lady pig.
Oh, Miss Piggy.
Miss Piggy.
Ah.
So what's green and smells like pork?
Oh.
That's gross.
No wonder I
Kermit's finger.
It.
Thank you. Move on.
You've never heard that before?
Yeah.
Oh.
I put it out of my mind.
No,
that's gross. I like Kermit.
Do you really?
Yeah.
What do you like about Kermit?
How can you not like Kermit?
Huh?
Yeah, well, how can you not like Kermit? He's cute and funny and sweet.
Hmm?
He's cute and funny and sweet.
Yeah?
I love Kermit.
Did some pretty insidious things to Miss Piggy.
I know.
Don't you think?
No, only in your dirty mind.
I didn't write the joke. I just know it. Don't you agree?
I'm sure I'm going to forget it again.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side?
Hey, look at that. It's Kermit the Frog. Isn't that nice?
Rainbow.
Oh! Frogs love to fly.
Frogs love to be socked.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we got a lot to go here. Here is Mike next on Stump the Jokes Are. Let's hear it, Mike.
Hey, dude, good morning.
What's up?
Young married couple having problems, so they go to see a marriage counselor. Marriage counselor looks at him and says, why don't you tell us something you have in common? The husband says,
wow, we're there already.
My crank.
What does he say?
Well, he says, that's two of us that don't give wah, wah, wah.
What did he say?
It's two of us that don't get wah, wah, wah.
They don't give, I think.
Wasn't funny, was it?
Sorry.
No.
Okay. All right, Sam, you're next here on the KGB. What's going on?
Well, only for your show will we sit on hold just to have our spirits crushed.
Thank you. Stand by. You're next.
All right.
Let's hear it.
Well, you got three guys stuck in a desert. You got an Irish guy, you got a French guy, and you got the Polack. Irish guy's walking around, finds one of those little genie pots and rubs it, and the genie pops out and says, you have three wishes. Irish guy says, oh, how I wish I were back in Ireland. Poof, he's back in Ireland. Rents an airplane, flies back over the desert, drops the pot, and, well, the French guy's out one day, and he finds it. He picks it up, does the same thing, rubs it, genie pops out, says, you have two wishes. French guy says, oh, how I wish I were back in France. Poof, he's back in France. Does the same thing, flies over, drops the pot in the desert, Polack's walking around, he finds it, picks it up, rubs it, genie pops out and says, you have one wish. The Polack guy says, oh, how I wish.
My friends were back here with me.
No.
How long did you hold, Sam? Do you know?
20 minutes.
Half an hour? Nice. That's a pity. Probably could have cured polio or something like that in that half hour. Dave! What's going on, Dave?
Hey, how's it going?
Tip top, let's hear it.
Hey, how many Raider fans does it take to change a light bulb?
Sports humor. I just can't get enough of it.
That's the only reason I told that joke is to hear that.
Well, we'll drop it on you in 1 second here. How many Raider fan does it take to change a light bulb?
Can I give it to you?
Yeah.
It takes seven. Six to tell you how great the old one is one was and one to change the light bulb.
Yeah.
Sports humor. I can't get enough of it.
There you go.
If only it was funny.
Well, you whatever.
Know? You know, that's Letterman doing that saying right mm-hmm. there. Sports humor. I can't get I remember. It was way, way, way long ago because I recorded this thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He was in Los Angeles. This was before he had his talk show.
Really?
Yep. He was in Los Angeles being interviewed for something. And he was standing next to Tommy Lasorda.
Uh-huh.
He was interviewing Tommy Lasorda for something. I don't know what it was. And he'd asked Tommy something. And Tommy was going off on some nutty story about some batter who'd done some crazy thing.
Uh-huh.
And Letterman is just barely tolerating him. And Tommy's barely able to contain himself as he's sputtering out the end of the story because it's the funniest thing ever. And then he goes, sports humor. I just can't get enough of it.
I taped
totally
that
rubbed
too.
It in his face.
I taped that too. That was the best of KTLA, remember?
Is that what it was?
Like, 40 years of KTLA Channel 5 in Los Angeles.
Wow.
Hang on.
Isn't that interesting?
No.
Okay. Let's go with Blind Stan next here on the KGB. What's up?
Hey, what's happening?
How you doing, pal?
I'm on my way to dialysis in a minute.
All right. Yes. When are you going to get that new kidney?
As soon as I get the phone call. So hurry up and wait.
Okay.
All right. Real quick. What did Helen Keller do when she fell off a cliff?
This has potential. Helen Keller jokes are usually pretty good.
They're always funny.
Let me ask you something, Blind Stan.
Uh-oh.
How did Helen Keller burn her ear?
Answer the iron.
Yes. How did she burn her other ear?
I can't remember that one.
They called back.
Okay.
Why doesn't Helen Keller skydive?
Scares the hell out of her dog.
Yeah, you got to know all the blind jokes. All right, what did Helen Keller do when she fell off a cliff?
What did Helen Keller do?
Dude, what happened to you?
I tied my tongue. What did Helen Keller do when she fell off her cliff? She screamed her hand off.
Hey, Blind Stan.
Yeah.
You're going to go golfing at La Costa.
As long as it's at night.
We're going to send you the night passes, exactly.
Oh,
hang on, dude.
All right.
Nicely done.
I wondered how he was going to do that, because I've always seen that as the visual of this is her screaming as she goes down the cliff.
Sprain her wrist.
Clever.
All right, Don, you're next here on Stump the Joke Czar. Let's hear it.
Good morning, guys and gals.
Morning.
All right, there's two old men about 70 years old out in the sticks, way out in the sticks, sitting on the porch in their chairs, pretty much watching the grass grow. Anyway, a frog jumps on the porch. They don't pay much attention to it. All of a sudden, they hear, "Kiss me, and I'll turn into a beautiful young princess and do anything that you'd like." They kind of look at each other like, "How did you throw your voice like that?" A couple minutes later, the frog jumps over a little closer. Same thing. "Kiss me, I'll turn into a beautiful young princess and do anything you'd like." They look at each other, "Okay, it's not funny anymore." He said, "I didn't do it." Frog jumps up in one of the old men's laps. Says, "Kiss me, I'll turn into a beautiful young princess and do anything that you'd like." The old man grabbed the frog, put him in his pocket. The other old man looks at him, says, "Hey, you didn't hear what that frog said? You're not going to kiss it?" The other old man looked at him and replied,
"Yeah, I did hear what he said, but I thought it was neater to have a talking frog."
Old men are funny, aren't they? All right, Dave, you're next here on Stump the Joke Czar. Let's hear it.
Hey, how do you make Martha Stewart cry twice?
This doesn't have anything to do with the bedroom curtains, does it?
Yep. I hang it up.
Okay, see you later.
Oh, no.
Michael Pollan would,
would
have a stroke if he heard that joke. Yeah. Mike, you're on the KGB. What's going on?
How you doing?
Hey, man.
Got a joke for you.
Bring.
Okay, what was Elvis's last hit?
The bathroom floor.
Hang on.
Okay, Don, you made it. You're on Stump the Joke Czar. Let's hear it.
Hey, Dave. Belated St. Patrick's Day joke. Patrick walks into a pub in Ireland and orders 3 pints of beer. Bartender brings him. He drinks them, orders 3 more. Bartender brings him, and he says, "You know, Patrick, I don't mind bringing you one at a time." And he says, "Oh, no, you don't understand. It's my brothers. They have all left Ireland, and we swore whenever we had a pint of beer, we'd have 3 to be drinking together." Next day, he comes in, and he orders 2 pints of beer. And the bartender says, "Oh, Patrick, I'm so sorry you've lost one of your brothers." And he said, oh, no, it's not my brother's. It's...
He said, it's me. I quit drinking.
Close. My wife. I quit drinking.
What? No.
It's what we said. Get out.
Get it?
Oh, a Bill Clinton joke. Can't pass that up. Let's hear it, Joe.
How you doing, Dave?
Tip top. Talk to me.
Okay, it's 3 in the morning, and President Clinton's being chauffeured home after partying all night. And he happens to look out the window, and he notices that they're driving on the yellow brick road.
Really?
And so he tells the chauffeur, pull over, Trixie. And so he gets out and hears the scarecrow talking and the Tin Woodsman and the Cowardly Lion behind this bush. So he goes around the bush, and he sees them all talking there. And they go, hello, Mr. President. They go, you know what? The great Oz should be showing up here. You know, he gave him a heart and him a brain, and maybe you'd like to ask him for something. And then President Clinton says,
I don't know. Dorothy looks pretty nice.
What'd you say?
Hey, it's a joke about Oz, and you take Dorothy because you want... I know, it's funny, isn't it? Bill, you're on the KGB.
Hey, Dave. Why is Helen Keller's leg wet?
Here it comes.
Because her dog is blind, too.
So long. Hey, Brian.
Hello.
Let's hear it.
Yeah, man. All right, man. Why did Helen Keller's dog run away?
You'd run away, too, if your name was...
All
right. That's funny.
Huh?
I'm laughing. Not allowed to laugh now?
Of course you're allowed to laugh. Brian.
We're now.
It's here, buddy.
Okay, a Polish guy gets back from his honeymoon. All his buddies are real excited. Take him out to the bar and say, hey, man, how was it? He says...
That's it?
We're there. I'm making it quick for you, man.
All right. Well, thank you. I appreciate it. You know how I like it fast. What'd he say?
He says, yeah, I could have nailed her.
Because he's Polish, Shell. Don't you know nothing?
What do you know about it, you dumb Polak?
Brian.
Yeah.
You're going golfing at La Costa.
Hey, I got a follow-up one if you want to hear that.
No, stop. Stop on top, buddy. Trust me. Trust me on that. Stop on the top. Go out a hero. All right, we got to do a timeout here on the KGB. I want you to start thinking about your favorite movies of all times. We're going to assign each of us here a bracket. You got to choose 16 favorite movies. Can you do it?
That's tough. Man. Start writing them down.
Chainsaw and I were talking about whether or not we should distribute a list of the 250 all-time greatest movies. Yeah, I'm personally against that because I think it should come from your head. What do you want to do? Do you want the list or not?
It might help to be an idea starter.
Yeah, I think it would help me.
Because when I cheated before I did, when I suggested that, I'd already looked at a list. And it's like, God, I hate most of those movies, but out of the 100, you know, there's 10 or 15 that I like, and I was reminded.
Right.
So do you want to cheat or not?
So it's not like cheating off of someone's master list. It's just helping you remember your favorite films.
Since we all have the same master list?
Yeah.
Right. Use it?
Right.
It'd be helpful.
Okay. We'll use it then. All right. Can you, Emily, can you make a copy of that for Shelley, Boyer, myself? Chainsaw's already got his. And we'll choose our four brackets. How are we going to choose the brackets? What are the brackets, Chain?
Well, there's the there's four different brackets, and it's arbitrary. Just
what do they call them?
They are now called by their region. So there's the Phoenix bracket, the Rutherford bracket, the Seattle bracket, and the other bracket, wherever they're playing. They're not calling them the East, West, North, and South anymore.
Dean of American Sportscasters?
I know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have them committed to memory at this
point. All right.
The Atlanta Regional, the East Rutherford Regional. I believe it's the Denver-Phoenix Regional and the St. Louis Regional. Ha-ha!
Okay. Well, how about if we break them up by our regions? Like, Dave, you might be the St. Louis region.
Well, which one are you going to be?
What do you want? Who do you want?
I would be the Pacific region.
Okay. Is there a Pacific region? There is no Pacific region.
That'd be the Phoenix. That'd be closest.
Okay. What was Chainsaw going to be then, since you're both Californians? Mm-hmm. See, I might have already thought of that. I didn't say it out loud.
You want to be arbitrary?
That was a bad idea.
I'll take St. Louis.
Okay. I'll take Rutherford.
Okay. And that leaves Atlanta for Shelley. Is that okay?
Sweet.
And that means Duke and Texas.
Okay.
You got to be happy with it.
Yeah.
I took Rutherford because you kind of.
What's that? What was that?
I don't know. Even I didn't hear what I said.
No, UConn's in Phoenix Regional of all places.
What?
I know. That's why they.
I hate that.
I know.
All right. Let's go ahead and do a traffic update, and then we'll bust them out here next on the KGB.
Slow traffic northbound 15, where there's a crash right around.
Stop. Sorry. That was my bad. I was saying stop to me, not to you. Sorry.
You meant me, right?
No, I meant me.
I meant me go.
Yes, you go.
Me go.
Me go. You
me stop. You go.
All right. The next word you hear will be Ruth 66.
Thank you so much. Northbound 15 has crashed just past El Cajon Boulevard. Traffic backed up behind a big fat wreck out in the northeast county. I mean, northbound 67. It's approaching Maple View. Traffic slow behind that. And another wreck, north 805. This one behind Balboa. Traffic backed up terribly. Westbound 52 showing a backup from the 125 all the way to Mast. Westbound 8 slow Jackson Drive to Lake Murray, then College to Waring, then 805 to Texas. Westbound 94 slows from Federal into downtown. Slow in the South Bay, north 805 Plaza to the 94, then Balboa to the 52. South 5 heavy from Poinsettia all the way to Manchester. South 15 packed solid from the 78 slow to Mercy. At Mattress Discounters, you'll save 20 to 30% off all Sealy and Simmons pillow top mattress sets. This sale won't last long, so hurry in to Mattress Discounters, where you'll find quality brands for less. I'm Ruth 66 with ESC 101.5 KGB.
This is KGB. And it's Dave, Shelley, and Shane start with you. Thanks for switching us on. Final Four kicks off in a little less than an hour, actually, isn't it? Is it 9 o'clock this morning, Shane?
9:25 is the first tip-off game.
There you go. And just like last year when we did the National Celebrity Annoying Association, the NCAAs, each of us being Dave, Shelley, Chainsaw, and Boyer, we took a bracket, and we chose an annoying celebrity. This time, we're going to choose some of our favorite movies, and we'll attach it to a team, and we'll find out in a couple of weeks here, sometime in April, what is the all-time greatest movie, depending on which basketball team it's attached to, wins the Final Four. So, what do I have? I can't figure this out.
You have East Rutherford. It's the lower left bracket. Those 16 teams.
With, like, St. Joseph's?
That's your number one seed, and your number two seed down at the bottom is Oklahoma State.
Okay. Okay. Emily, you going to score all this stuff for us?
Okay. I'm ready.
Thank you.
Cool. How are we going to determine? We're going to go by a round and determine who goes first.
I think we got to go one at a time, don't we?
Right, one at a time. So who goes first with the number one pick?
Let's just go alphabetically like we always do.
All right.
That would be Boyer, Chainsaw, Dave, Shelley.
Okay.
All right, Boyer.
Okay, I'm in the Phoenix region. My number one pick is Godfather.
Ah! You got number two, buddy.
I know, but that's the greatest film of all time.
Is it?
Yeah.
All right.
Godfather one?
There is no Godfather 1. It's only Godfather.
Godfather 2 was the best movie of all time.
Jane.
Boy, I hate to do this for a couple of reasons, but I'm going to go Shawshank Redemption for my number one pick.
Okay.
Kentucky, leaving Godfather 2 for somebody else.
Shell?
Oh, is it me? I thought I was last.
Oh, you are last. Yeah. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll take Godfather 2.
There you go, buddy.
Okay, and then I will take It's a Wonderful Life. And
sure.
If I write this down, do I write it?
Write it next to your number one pick in Atlanta,
Duke.
Which is Duke.
Okay.
Okay, Boyer, we're back to you.
I'm going to take, now I'm picking 16, right?
Or am
I
picking
you're picking your two seed. My two seed, I'm going to pick Cool Hand Luke.
Jay?
I will go Casablanca.
Damn it.
Okay, my number two is going to be Star Wars.
And my number two will be...
You're only on number two, baby.
I know.
You're stuck on it.
I'm
going to
do Goodfellas. Goodfellas.
Boyer?
I'm going to take Caddyshack.
Oh! You okay over there, buddy?
No.
What's the matter?
Because that was my next pick.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yeah, isn't it, though?
You can choose something else, you know.
Oh, I know.
Right along.
Duh. Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Good one. Take an ET for number three. All right, what's the deal?
Nothing.
What? What is going on here? What are you doing to me? What kind of shot are you taking at me?
Vern is just chuckling at last two choices. Star Wars and ET. I'm sorry.
Okay.
And Vern, we love Vern.
Who does?
Ruth.
I'm not in here.
I'm going to take A Christmas Story for my number three.
Those are obviously very popular.
Oh, my movies.
Those are very popular.
The ones that you lost.
Huh.
All right, boy, you're up.
Got to go with Great Escape.
Oh.
There's another one on my list. All right. I like Midnight Run.
Midnight Run. I'm taking Die Hard for number four.
Oh, that's another one on my list.
Gee whiz. Boyer. Number five.
Number five.
Did we skip me?
Oh, I'm sorry. We skipped Shelley's number five.
I'll take Sling Blade for number five.
Okay.
My number five is 12 Angry Men.
It's hard to get through.
What's you saying, Dave?
No.
Why was that, Dave?
All right, Shane. Number five.
I like Wizard of Oz.
Okay. I'm going to take Gladiator.
Kill a Mockingbird.
Okay, Boyer, number six.
Number six, you got to go with Dirty Dozen.
Okay, Jay. What was that, Emily? Slow down.
Slow down just 1 second.
Okay, hang on. Let's all take a breath here. Let Emily catch up.
Okay.
Scorekeeper, you up to date?
I need Boyer's number six.
Boyer's number six is?
Dirty Dozen.
Dirty Dozen.
Okay, thanks.
Great movie. You know, if that's on, I'm watching it, and I've seen it at least 15 times.
Right.
Okay.
You ready?
Jane,
ready, Emmy?
Number six.
Patton.
Okay, I'm going to go Die Hard. Oh, I already took Die Hard. I'm going to take a Young Frankenstein.
What are we on, number six?
Yep.
I'm going to take One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Yuck.
Love that movie.
God.
It's whack. It's like it's a headache.
Don't be on choose it, Chainsaw.
Heroin to get it. Good choice.
what are you saying, Dave?
Number seven.
The Sting. Oh, God, I'm just getting scorched here. Oh, it's my turn.
Mm-hmm.
I beg your pardon. Animal House. Has anyone done that yet?
Nope. Okay, number seven for me is going to be Gump.
And I'm going to do number seven, Braveheart.
Good choice. Good movie.
Great movie.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Boyer, number eight.
To me, I'm going to take Jaws.
Great picks, people. Pee-pee.
My number eight is going to be Princess Bride.
I think I'm next.
Who'd we... I'm sorry, Chainsaw's next.
I'll take Prince... No. A Hard Day's Night.
Okay, I have Princess Bride for number eight. Shelley, you're number eight.
You got Princess Bride. I'm going to say Back to the Future.
That's fun.
Okay, Boyer, number nine.
It's over to me for nine. I'm going to take... I got to go with... Mr. Roberts.
That's a great movie.
I'll go Airplane.
Oh, good pull.
Airplane 2 was on yesterday. Not a good movie.
No.
My number nine is going to be Rear Window.
Oh, that was my
next one. Well, why don't you take it?
Because you just are just wonderful at picking movies.
My number nine is going to be The Usual Suspects.
Yeah. I got to see that again. That was so good.
That movie freaks me out, but I can't not watch it.
Boyer, you're number 10.
My number 10 is North by Northwest.
Okay. Chain, number 10.
Saving Private Ryan.
My number 10, Clarice.
Great film.
Silence of the Lambs for me. Shell?
What am I at? Number
10.
10. I'll take Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid.
Another one off my list.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome.
Mm-hmm. Number 11, Boyer.
Vertigo.
Hitchcock and a lot of props, dog. I'll take Chinatown next.
I'll go Maltese Falcon.
Okay.
Is this number 11?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go Pulp Fiction.
Hang on, I missed Chains, sorry.
I had Chinatown.
Thanks.
Did you go 11, Shell?
Yes,
Pulp 12, Fiction. Boyer.
12, I'm going to go with American Graffiti.
Good one.
Love that film. It's my hometown. Dive on my dust all.
That's great. Number 12.
God. Tough room.
It's a tough room. Stalag 17.
Good. Is anyone taking The Great Escape?
Yes.
Yeah, I have that.
Okay, then I will take The Great Race. Number 12, Shelley.
Yeah. Psycho, number 12.
Hitchcock. Dog money.
That's what they all said about him.
He's getting his props, dog.
Hitch, you dog. What up? Everything good in the hood? Word. Fat money out. Peace, props.
Yeah.
Street date.
All right. Let's 13 to you, Boyer.
A bullet.
Oh, that's a goodie. Did I say goody?
Yeah.
Goody.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. Okay. Dirty Harry.
Number 13, I'm going Pirates of the Caribbean.
Is the movie 7 that Brad Pitt won with the box? And then my number, what is it, 13?
Yep.
Up to? Okay.
14, Boyer.
It's weird, but it's still interesting. Taxi Driver.
Nothing weird about it.
Watch it the other day. It's still great.
14, Chain.
Grapes of Wrath.
Good one. 14 for me. A River Runs Through It.
And for me, L.A. Confidential.
I thought you already took that one.
She had Usual Suspects.
Usual Suspects. Yeah. What? How did you know which one I had confused it with?
Because it's Kevin Spacey.
15 to me?
Yeah.
Spinal Tap.
Please don't let that win.
It's funny.
Please don't let it win. Chain.
Did I pick Sunset Boulevard yet? No, I'll do that.
I don't think so. I gotta be careful here now. Even though these are probably gonna bomb out right away.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I know what I'm going to take. I'm at 15, right?
Mm-hmm.
True Romance.
I always like that movie. And I'm going to take Gone with the Wind for number 15.
Okay, Boyer, final choice.
God, this is so tough. I'm going to take...
I hate this! I only have one more.
It's a 16 seed, and it's going to lose.
It's going to lose.
Old School.
Oh, cool.
Really? You're putting Old School?
I was thinking School of Rock.
I was too.
Yeah.
I like that movie. School of Rock was good. Old School was like, okay.
It was fun. Yeah. School of Rock was just insane. Did I pick All the President's Men yet, Emily? Could you scan my list?
I can't believe you took 16 to get to President's Men.
No, you didn't.
I know. That's a miss on me, but I'll take that. All the President's Men.
I am going to take for my 16th choice, only because I'm gay and a mom now.
Musical?
Huh?
A musical?
You wouldn't have believed my conversations that I was having with the moms in my life yesterday. I am such a mom. I've turned into a mom. And I have such appreciation for moms anymore. Oh, my God. You have no heart. It is being a mom.
You're right.
Holy crap. Let me tell you.
Let alone being the mom and the dad.
What's that?
Let alone being the mom and the dad.
Oh, I'm not a dad anymore. I'm just totally mom.
Oh, okay.
I've just gone mom. I can't do both.
Are you lactating yet?
Are you a MILF?
I'd like to think that I was.
I don't know. He's kind of flat chains.
I know I would.
Yeah, me too, buddy.
Finding Nemo is going to be my 16th.
That's a cute movie.
And I'm going to take for 16 The Sting, if no one's chosen it.
Great movie.
Sting wasn't taken? Sting,
I thought it was.
I have Sting at 7
for me. Then for number 16, I will take Being John Malkovich. Yeah, I know. What? 16th seed.
I like John Malkovich.
I do like John.
Hey, you know what? I don't
hot.
Think there's a clinker, really. Hardly any clinker. Hardly any clinkers in the bunch.
Really? Really? My number 2 and 3 clunked.
Princess Bride.
They're great films.
Princess Bride's a clinker?
It is
no.
A great
wait a minute.
Film.
Is Princess Bride a clinker, Ruth?
No.
I think so.
Oh, my
it's a
God.
Great movie.
Have you ever
of
seen it?
Of all time?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen it.
Yeah. All right, let me hear your top four, everybody. Boyer.
I have Godfather, Cool Hand Luke, Caddyshack, and Great Escape.
I would watch every one of those, no matter what. I would watch every one
those
of those.
Those are keepers.
If it was on TV, I'd stop right there. Chain?
I had Midnight Run, Shawshank, Casablanca, and I forget my number 3. Emily, help me.
This is so scribble on.
Raiders of the Lost Ark,
yes.
I think.
See, I got to watch all four of those, too.
I have a question about one of Chain's.
Yeah.
Because I hadn't heard it before. Your number 12, something 17.
Stalag. 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 Stalag 17. I would watch every one of those. I would watch every one of the movies with about 2 exceptions.
Oh, stop it. I can hear you.
And, Chain, when I hold this paper, Shelly,
shut
you
up.
Can't hear what I'm saying.
Yes.
The only exceptions were on her list. And I know the exceptions for you are on my list.
No, that is incorrect. I like E.T. very much.
If you choose me last, I have to go last, so I was left with kind of the dregs. A lot
nice
of
nice try.
Well, and a lot of these I haven't seen, so I didn't know.
We chose 52 movies.
I know, but I don't know a lot of
64.
These.
Or 64, whatever.
Right.
Don't ask me to do the math. Godfather 2, Star Wars, E.T., Die Hard are my top four.
Great
good,
film.
Shell?
My top four, It's a Wonderful Life, Goodfellas, A Christmas Story, and Sling Blade.
These are good.
Yeah.
It's the National Cinematic Achievement Association,
hey!
As suggested by listener here this morning.
Come on.
They've all been assigned to teams. So who's playing who at 9 o'clock here this morning? We'll figure this out. You know what? Let's figure this out. Let's figure out who's playing, what movie is playing what movie.
Okay.
For Chainsaw's Sportscast, which is coming up next here on the KGB. And let's get this traffic update. Or did we do 8 o'clock already?
We did 8 o'clock.
Perfect. Here we go. Because you cannot choose every single movie ever made. But I swear to God. Dave, how could you leave out Boxing Helena?
Get out.
All right, it's KGB, the Dave Shelley and Chainsaw Radio Show. Let's get now right to the Chainsaw with sports. And as soon as we can get the IT on it, we will have our top 16 brackets posted on the website so you can track its progress. And we will ultimately decide in the coming weeks what is the all-time champion movie.
Mm-hmm.
With an update now on sports, here's the Saga Bowl.
Well, good morning, and thank you very much, David, and hello again, everybody in the sports world. Indeed, the NCAA Men's College Basketball Tournament tips off in less than an hour for the first game, and then all through the day today, the first half of the first round. 64 teams, 32 will play today in 16 games, 32 will play tomorrow in 16 games, and the winners there will play on Saturday and Sunday, and by Monday, we'll be down to the Sweet 16, David. And a reminder, our number one seeds for the greatest movies of all time, I have Shawshank Redemption.
Or
Shawshank Reduction Sauce attached.
That sounds good.
Yeah, it does. Attached to Kentucky, number one seed. Number one seed, St. Joe's, is Dave's, and you picked?
Godfather 2.
Godfather 2. Number one, Duke, is in Shelley's bracket, and she attached that to? Her number one pick overall?
It's a Wonderful Life.
And the number one pick overall for Boyer, attached to Stanford in the Phoenix bracket, is?
Godfather.
Beautiful. So Godfather, It's a Wonderful Life, Shawshank Reduction Sauce, and Godfather 2.
Charlie, is that your favorite movie?
What, It's a Wonderful Life?
Yeah.
Was that your number one pick?
I thought it would be the strongest.
Oh, okay.
And it's a great movie. I mean, I hadn't seen it most of my adult life until you guys hipped me to it.
That is a...
It's a great movie.
I would say a controversial number one seed, and they could win it all. If Duke wins it all, It's a Wonderful Life will be the number one pick, the champion.
I'd be
greatest,
happy with that. That's my
all-time movie.
That is my all-time favorite
and
movie.
And it is a great movie.
Gotta watch it every Christmas.
But yeah, is that your all-time favorite movie?
Probably not.
What is it? Choose! Now!
Well, for a long time, it was The Big Chill, but you guys are going to hate that.
No. I like The Big Chill.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
You didn't even pick it. Well, I didn't think it would be a strongie.
Everyone had a
It doesn't matter what the movie is. It matters what the basketball team is.
Right.
Why didn't you choose The Big Chill?
Well, because I thought it was supposed to be a strong contender, and like... You guys would never accept The Big Chill as the number one movie of all time, the best movie of all time.
We have to if it wins.
I asked you in the commercial break if I had to see the movies before, and you said no. So I thought, right. Well, we're going for the strongest movie.
Right.
The one you really think is the best movie.
Oh, okay.
I know my personal tastes are quirky.
All I chose were my personal taste. That's all
well,
I chose.
And plus, I had to scramble for some because you chose some of my favorites, too.
Right, yeah. That happened with all of us. But all I took were my personal toys. I mean, no one here is going to choose The Great Race. Or Pirates of the Caribbean, or True Romance, or Finding Nemo.
Well, no one's going to choose One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, and that is one of my favorites. I love The Usual Suspects. Pulp Fiction was fine. Oh, Jesus Christ.
I'm listening, David. Dude, we can hear you. Shelley is the only one who can.
And I do love Goodfellas. I love Ray Liotta in that movie.
Enough said.
Shut up. Oh, you know, I hope Duke stomps your little teams.
Didn't hold that paper well enough, dude.
My little teams?
Yes, your little teams.
My little teams.
So your little movies go down in little flames.
Competition's getting ugly.
Chicks aren't happy unless guys are heartbroken and downtrodden.
Oh,
that's right.
Good God, this is a competition between all of us.
You're never happy till we're holding our nuts, are you?
I'm the only chick involved in this competition.
You're the one who says, why are you so damn competitive? So when we get competitive now, this is a competition. You can't butter your bread on both sides, darling.
You are never happy.
You can, actually. It's pretty tasty. I've done that a couple times. It's a little messy as long as you don't mind eating that way.
Well, if you do it on a grilled cheese.
Marble night. Jane, were you doing something?
Meanwhile, in the National Bath.
We go to a lot of movies. I love the movie previews. Why is it whenever you're watching a movie preview, you always feel like you have to comment on it to the person you're with? You're always like, I'm not going to see that movie. I'm going to wait for that on video. Mm-hmm. Well, you think about it, it's just a commercial for the movie. You know, you never sit at home watching TV. I'm not buying that cereal. I don't like cereals with raisins in them. What's your take on that commercial? And movies are great for dates, too, right? Unless it's a movie about a serial killer. Because then there's never an appropriate time to make a move. Yeah. He just strangled that little girl. Hello. Getting comfy. You ever not seen someone's favorite movie? They get furious. You ever seen Goodfellas? What are you saying? Apparently I'm saying your mother's a whore.
Skitball Association. The Lakers beat the Clippers 106-103. In other sports, David.
Stand by for details on the Hamwool Open coming up here. Chainsaw.
NFL. 8:36:45. This is your 101.5 KGB Sports Network.
Chainsaw brought to you by Fred Hall's Fishing Tackle and Boat Show. It's going on through the 21st at the Del Mar Fairgrounds. Here's Route 66.
Slow traffic in the East County around a wreck westbound, ages past Lake Murray Boulevard. Westbound 94 still slows from the 805 now into downtown. North 805 much, much better, only heavy at Balboa. South 5 slows in the coast, La Costa Avenue down to Manchester. South 15 still stop and go traffic from the 78 to Poway Road. North 15 slows right at the 8. Help San Diego's Goodwill Industries provide training and jobs to people with disabilities by bringing your gently used clothing and household items to the nearest Goodwill store or donation center. Open 7 days a week. Call Goodwill, 1-888-446-6394. I'm Ruth 66 with Dave Shelley and Chainsaw, 101.5 KGB.
We're on the KGB. It's Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw getting ready for our big golf tournament. It's the Hamel Open, brought to you by Barona Valley Ranch Resort Casino. Hooking up once again with our good buddies at Steel Canyon. Monday, March 29th. It is sold out, so there's only one way for you to play.
Laying down that big old fairway. Don't want no hackers to get in my way.
Who's singing this, Chainsaw?
The boys and me.
Peter Jacobson. Yes, it is. Peter Jacobson, rookie on the Champions Tour now.
On a rainy day.
Great PGA champion. The late, great Payne Stewart on background vocals on this song. I need to check a phone number. Hang on one second here.
Gonna try another swing today. I love to play. We love it. I love to play.
No, let me try this one. Hey, is that you?
Yeah.
Oh. Hey, I thought we'd talk about the tournament for a little bit here.
Yeah, you know what?
Did you hear that Sombrero Mexican food has confirmed?
Cool.
Yeah, I saw that on the liner yesterday.
That's so great. We're going to be eaten.
Yeah.
Oh,
we are going to be well fed.
A king.
This is going to be like third or fourth year that Sombrero has hooked up with us. Did you hear that it sold out?
Yeah, you know what? I called because for some reason...
Hey, just follow me along, okay? I can do it. It's his first day on the air. Did you hear there's only one other way to play now because it's sold out? Promo!
Yeah. I didn't know you were talking to me.
What are you doing?
I didn't know you were talking to me.
Yes, I'm talking to you.
Yeah. There's one way to play, sure.
Yes, there's only one way to play, and what is that?
You got to go online and bid on it.
Go online?
Yeah.
What's the website?
101khb.com.
And then what do you do?
Go to the thing right there on the front page on the left and click on, click here.
Okay, let me click on that. Click here.
Mm-hmm.
And then what?
There's a list of people you can bid on.
Oh, yeah. I see that list. I see that list. It lists the foursome you can play in and what the current bid is.
$655.
That places us in first. Where's Shelly Shemp there?
Okay, I'm going to let you go. See ya.
Dave, I'll try to help you out if you'd like.
He doesn't have his game face on today. I don't know what's going on. I mean, I'm calling on my boy here to do a little stomp on Emily and Chucko, and he's just not ready to play. Let me try him back.
Okay.
Let me try. Oh, God.
Maybe you got the imposter promo.
Okay, are you ready to play now?
Well, what were you doing? I was ready.
You were messing it up.
No, I can't. First of all, were you playing something behind me? Because I can't hear. I can't. Whatever you were playing, I couldn't hear.
Come on, promo.
Who cares? I mean, come on. We have to do our brag routine now here.
That's why I called you, to brag in the
Well, follow me along. You're trying to take control, and I'm trying to get you to follow. God. Let's be lead.
Like Dave doing that mossy
Shut
spot.
Up, boy. I was calling to tell you that I could not log on to the system, but the last time I looked, you and I were kicking the crud out.
Will you just let me lead? Just follow me along and brag, okay?
Okay.
I don't even have the will to brag now.
No,
can't you just play a sound effect of Bromo?
Yes, I can, actually. Let me see. Let me get the Bromo page up here.
Good
see
idea,
boy. Just use the sound effects.
Well, if you don't need me, then I'll go.
Okay, here we go. Hey, he hung up. What a homo. Now his feelings were all hurt.
My feelings, Dave.
Well, you know, he does that. Sometimes I'm trying to lay out a bit, you know. I've got a start, I've got a middle, and I've got a finish.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, crap, let me go to the finish right away. He's like, no, hang on.
He's like riding a wild horse, you know.
You know you gotta call him back now, though.
You talk to him, I don't want to. Oh, he's playing hard to want now.
It's crutch time, crud. What do you want?
Little baby.
Yeah, I got things to do.
What did he do? Run off to the ladies' room to cry? Perfectly good brag opportunity. bumbled. Mm. All right, here's how you play if you want to join our foursomes. Go to 101kgb.com. Follow the instructions on the Hamul Open. And you can bid to play in Shelly. You know, they labeled him a Shemp, you know.
His name is Mike.
Well, I wasn't going to do that to you. But
well, no, that's fine.
Now that it's on Internet Inc., it's confirmed.
Right.
So.
Just didn't say which Shemp.
No, it doesn't.
We need a number.
Mystery Shemp.
Yeah.
Are we up to six or seven?
I think we're at six.
I don't know. I don't know.
Already did six.
You guys are counting, not me.
Huh?
You were the ones who counted.
Did you lose count?
No, I didn't lose count. I never numbered them. That was your job.
The current bid is $450. Mojo and the Hoofer at $400. Chainsaw and Boyer in the Hamul Open. $500 is the current bet. Bid. Emily and Chucko in second place.
Enjoy it while you can.
What do you know? Don't hear you walk around going,
What you sound like right now.
But there was a lot of that going on yesterday.
No.
A little bit.
Despite the cheating that took place. The cheating that took place.
Don't know what you're talking
about. Get them up there.
What happened to the chin dong for her?
Shut up.
You know what? I ordered a new one.
Oh, okay.
And I made it a chindong emergency.
So she owes us 30 minutes.
Oh,
right?
We got two quarter least. Hours retroactive.
Excellent.
That she owes us. Yeah.
Excellent.
Oh.
Did you go to the front desk, Emily?
Huh? Oh, yeah. And you know what?
I still contend I didn't cheat, so I shouldn't be stuck with the dang dong.
Good luck with that. Contend all you want, okay? And the fun part about it is since you snapped the chindong and you have to make
Romo
it up.
Romo broke it.
Actually. You put it on the hot equipment that broke it.
It melted.
It was,
nice try.
It was on thin ice. Like, it was getting there. When Bromo was wearing it, it broke.
No.
His fault.
No. Two retroactive quarter hours of my choice.
Oh, that's
good.
Sweet. Yeah. Like when Dad's
it's always immediate.
Mm-mm.
Uh-huh.
Mm-mm.
Emily, what did you check if it was
rules?
Serious?
This is such...
Is this your first day on the show?
Yes, apparently. This is crazy.
So, like when Nick Lachey is walking around the halls, Emily, get the dog out.
Hi, I got that papa.
Oh, that's sweet.
Yeah.
Oh.
So just remember, when there's some hottie walking around here, we're going to cash in our two quarter hours.
Usable in what, 1 minute increments?
No. No, we can't do that. That would be cheating and unfair.
Oh.
Okay, well, we'll do it that way if you want. Sure, if that's what you want, Emily. It was 30 minutes. 31-minute shots.
Read between the lines.
What?
Read between the lines.
Really? And then Abramowitz and I happen to be stomping the entire field with a current bid of $655. There's plenty of time for you to get in on the bidding. You have until, I think... late afternoon, a week from tomorrow, is when they're going to shut her down, Earl. 101KGB.com. That's where you go to bid on the Hamul Open. And that's brought to you by Barona. And we have all kinds of contests going on. There's going to be a longest drive, closest to the pin. Isn't Mossy Ford involved in this? Aren't they trying to give someone a free car? Mm-hmm. That was confirmed by Emily. I asked, and Emily confirmed.
Excellent.
Congratulations.
You could be driving Emily's car.
You know, there's an art to being concise, and I have yet to master it, but that's ridiculous.
I gave you the info.
Where is it?
In your mailbox.
Where?
Your email.
It's not updated.
You have the most updated, even if it is like a past date, I thought.
It doesn't say anything about the car. I've seen newer stuff.
Yeah, so have I.
I've seen newer stuff. That is old information.
Okay.
So you are wrong. And what do we do with people who make mistakes and cause train wrecks here on the show? Mm-hmm. That's another quarter hour.
Oh, that is
we'll
so
be
sweet.
Lenient and just call it a quarter hour. So 45 1 minute increments with the chin dong. I think 2004 is covered. Also participating, Golf Mart, Aldala, F Street, and a Better Body Salon and Day Spa. Will your girlfriend be running around hijacking everybody's gooey lube, lovey lube?
I hope so.
When you're out?
Well, you know, you reach a certain point where it's time to replenish the supplies.
Hang on a second. Let me try this number once more. He's still off in the bathroom crying.
Deeply wounded.
Hello?
Hey, Kelly, it's Dave Shelley and Chainsaw calling from KGB, where we're doing our radio show here this morning. How are you?
Dave, stop that.
How are you?
I'm good.
So, Sombreros is going to be on, huh?
Yes, they are.
Excellent. We only called because we know how much you'd like to be on the radio.
I know, thank you. I told Emily that I was trying to sneak in and tell her so you wouldn't do this to me.
No, I already knew that Sombreros was confirmed. I didn't care about that. We just wanted to ambush you. This is Kelly Kunkel, who wants everyone to know that she is leading the sales team, which outbilled every other radio station so far this year.
Huh?
What's up?
Congratulations, Kelly.
Weren't you bragging about that?
No, I don't think I was.
Hmm?
I think those are words that you said.
Didn't you call me and actually interrupt me in the middle of my day and bragging about it?
No.
Huh?
Oh, you're talking about the other thing, yes. Not about me. About me. I was just telling him how well KGB did.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
And weren't you telling me that you're the one who's leading that sales
team?
No,
I did not say that, Dave.
Weren't those your exact words?
No, they were not.
Weren't you telling me that despite the horrible management of Corey Cuddyback, that you...
and, I did not say that.
Some select others...
I hate to be on the air.
Upstairs there.
I thought you said you hated
Corey. Huh?
I thought you said you hated Corey.
No, she didn't say she hated him. She said she hated his management skills.
Oh, that's what
as a person, he's
right.
As a person,
you hate
he's
the
fine.
Action, not personal. The person.
Well, you know, Kelly's a thoroughbred, and thoroughbreds hate to be behind bumblers.
Well, yeah. What are you going
to do? You know what? I got April looming right ahead. I need to start working on April. I got to go.
Well, you told me to call and talk to you on the radio.
No, I did not.
I don't think you remember anything.
I'm not a very good radio person.
Wow.
I don't think you remember
anything.
Perfect. Properly.
Awesome.
You're hot. Hey, were you walking down the sidewalk on Granite Ridge yesterday? Were you out there?
I don't know. I walked to my car.
Ah, because there was a supermodel out there. I could swear it was you.
Thank you, Chaney.
Yeah.
She cuts a very impressive figure.
Right.
Oh, wow. Thanks. You can call and tell me that any day.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Right by the phone.
Okay. All right. I deeply regret the last quarter hour. I'll just go to commercial.
KGV is your concert connection. Rush. Now, the legacy continues. July 7th, Coors Amphitheater. Rush. The 30th anniversary tour. Neil Peart, Alex Lifeson, Geddy Lee.
Living in the limelight.
Powerful force of Rush. Back on stage to roll them again. July 7th, live at Coors Amphitheater. Reserve seats on sale this Saturday morning at 10. All Ticketmaster locations online at HOB.com or charge 619-220-TIXX. Rush. Presented by VH1 Classic. Part of the Coors Light Live Concert Series at Coors Amphitheater. Produced by House of Blues Concerts.
Good.